Hello everyone, how's it going? Dr. Incompetent here, and let's play some more Roots of Yggdrasil, shall we? Picking up on our loop here, and, well, our ship is down here, but we need to go higher and higher. This will remove a card from our deck for 3 time. A random encounter, we get an artifact for 6 time, but there's a danger because we will get caught and get a curse card. So, I can instead jump up here and explore this. This also has danger that they catch us. I don't know if it's definitive or not, but it doesn't look good. I'll go here and just not have any danger. Alright, so, ooh, cool. Blessings of Odin, so we can upgrade a card. So, I could upgrade my shrub, my lumberyard, or my barracks. Just mousing over to see what we get here. So this one doesn't destroy anything and gives you... Oh no, it does. If you play the lumberyard, you destroy a tree every turn, but it gives you +8 resources. Let's take this... the lumberyard just seems cooler. Flooded plains or underground river. Well, let's see if we can find some trees on the plains here. All right. So, we have a fair amount of resources. Old ruins. We need some. Well, we got a barracks. Excellente. We need some houses for that. And let's do that. One. Right. Two. Three. Now we're ready to upgrade, but if I can play this now and get some juice to open that up. I need more houses though. This is 3 per house. Yeah, let's build some more houses. Upgrade. Well, there's another military building. We know we need 2. But this requires, like a recreation, which I don't have. So does this, though. I'll get this. Oh, the water well is actually a recreation. Okay, never mind. Or an amenity or whatever. If I play this, I'll get 12 resources and 3 per turn. Can I afford another house? I feel like I can, and then I could play a water well and get even more. 15. Yeah, let's just get this down. And then now we could play a barracks and get enough military power to start exploring. So I'm gonna go, this just needs what? Adventure. I'm gonna clear this because it's so close to our place. I just wanna open up some more space. And, oh, I think I played the wrong one. Oh, no, no, never mind. No, I didn't. I was confused. What ended up happening there was, this will give me 11 military pie. It does not like being close to its buddy. I could put this here, but I need to get it into a location where, I didn't space that very well. I need this to be close enough to this guy, but this guy is kind of too centrally located. I'll probably have to wait until I uncover some territory. So given that, let's just build some more houses. Well, I could drop in an observatory wherever I want. That's fine. Let me remind myself of my artifacts. So, here's my base income. All buildings are 50% less. Man of action. I don't have an action card on me, it doesn't look like. Swan feather, good. Gain 2 might. And then, for each 2 population, I gain 1 resource per turn. So I should just play as many houses as I can anyway. Wait, I put down the wrong building. I don't know why I did that. I thought I was putting down a house. That was a mistake. Well, it'll give us some more might that we can actually use. It gives us enough might to just explore right here, so it's not actually the end of the world. It's fine. All right, now we'll end the turn. Yep, and we got a lot more military stuff, so not bad. Alright, here's our super lumber yard. Here we go. If I place this, I just get 40 resources per turn. Until we destroy all the trees, but that's a lot of resources. We'll take that, and we will end a turn. All right, open it up. Wonderful. Open it up. Give me an action card. Well, recycle actually might help me. Because I misplaced that barracks. But for now, let's just click on this and encounter at the runic altar. As you approach the altar, a man emerges from the shadows. He introduces himself as a traveler and offers to help, no strings attached. Choose an action card to add to your hand. I think. Oof, prolific is gross. We could have a huge turn here with prolific. Alright, so let me go ahead and say I need a military card in radius of this. So recycle actually will come in handy here. So what I'm going to do is recycle that, and, oh, well, okay, I didn't think of that the right way. It's okay to have done that, but it doesn't give it back to you. I don't know why I was thinking that it might do that for us, but it will not, but anyway, We'll put that there. We could put a shrub down. I think the best I saw is 18 somewhere. Oh, 16 is good. All right. Yes. I'm gonna prolific. And, you know, I already got to 15 supplies here, but look at how many supplies I have now. I could build just an extraordinary number of houses. It's pretty sweet. First of all, we have an adventure here. Let's do this. A burly blacksmith stands next to the forge. You can feel the forge's eater fading, yet he offers to reforge your resources. So I could transform into... I'm going to be greedy and go for the matter, because that's the long-term resource. I need a bunch of military stuff to... I need might all over the place, but that's okay. Here's an adventure. Sheesh, just lighthouses. As ramshackle as it gets, and look at all these artifacts lying around. It's a miracle the venom tides don't sweep this all away. Freyr, is that you, son? Oh my gosh, Njord. Beg pardon for startling you, Vikings. I'm afraid I was expecting, well, hoping for someone else. No, it's fine. We just weren't expecting to find someone living out here. Do you need help? We have room left on our ship. Ha! Do not waste your efforts on scum, strangers. Best leave me to clean these rotting oceans and await my son's return, or I may ruin your lives next. But feel free to take any artifacts I've dredged up from the depths with you. Their powers could shield you from the failures which have afflicted me. Something's off about this guy. I say we leave him alone for now and come by next time we get a chance. There might be more we can find out. So we can... It's you again. I fished out some new junk of my once beautiful ocean. They're worthless if you ask me, but I know you like those for some reason. I'll give you more of them. If you could just keep company to an old man like me, so we can give a bit of time to choose, or we could pay 50 to choose between three. I actually have so many supplies that I'll take the second option. I can have the verdant hoe. Upgrade a random card in hand when skipping a building draft, or each time a card with the exhaust keyword is played, draw a card. That's great. I like drawing. Oh, upgrade. Echoing Stone. Shuffle the exhaust pile into the draw pile. Draw one card per nearby amenity. Wow, that's pretty cool. I don't have any of this resource there to play it. I traded on my 8-year away. Well, this is an exhaust card. Plus 3 for each future tree exploited. I'll take the Lumberyard, because I can actually play it. Activate the sapling. You bet we will. Now, I could stop building houses because it's making them really expensive and we need a bunch of houses over here. Not sure. I have 12. So let's just place two more. and then call it a day. I'm not getting any might buildings. It's really sad. There's no room for it. We'll make room for it. So I get to draw because I played an exhaust card. I have another lumberyard, but I don't know if I have any places I can fit this thing. Oh, wait. There it is. Ugh, logger's camp. I have 7 cards in my exhaust pile, so this thing, I can't play it though, because I don't have 2 military buildings. So it tells you which trees are actually being worked, so you can't, like, double dip. It's interesting. He's ready to give me a free building. Finally, we got a barracks. Okay. So, we will put a barracks right here. 19 looks like the best I can do. Is that right? Wonderful. Ruins rebuilt. Okay. Blacksmith looks good. Got another barracks, actually. There we go. I have 47 might, so let's go this way. And I suppose that way. Shrub. I retain my builder's boon, so I'm just going to hold on to it. Uh-oh, they've attacked. They started a fire in our village. It'll spread and destroy buildings if we don't deal with it. Okay, so we gotta deal with it. How do we do that? Threat. Fire. Doesn't an armory defeat that? Yes, like a might building will defeat it. We did it. This gives you 30 per turn. Goodness gracious. There's a bunch of resources. All right, so we got 2 to explore. 1. Oh, I clicked on this. Well, I wanted to do that anyway. Okay, we got that area, and does this give it? Yes, that's what I'm talking about. It gets me back down here. Okay, perfect. it can be used to power a building, but I don't even need know if I need to. So this just needs two military buildings. Okay. I'm actually going to use my builder's poon to just build a house because... Well, no, wait. I need to build the... Wait for the price to go up. One, two, three, and then four. There we go. Oh, right. Arms factory. I need so many military buildings. There you go, water. All right. I mean, we're taking too long this time, but boy, are we getting a lot of amazing resources per turn. Okay, so they need three houses. Arms factory we can actually put down easily. We did move into this timeline of dusk, which is not as good, of course, but what can we do? We need three houses for that. Okay, one, two, three, and a barracks. Got it. Yes. So I think that means we can abandon ship, and, you know, we probably should. We only get 12 spare time. Just building everything. I'm going all in, exploring every single thing. I mean, I have some time because it does. I don't think it matters as long as you leave before that. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we can get something here. I do like Workers Guild. I do not have... I need to build another path. I don't have enough might to make it. The amount of resources I have is just insane. Okay, getting there. I need a water well or something to get the might. Okay. Alright, what is this? Sweet, so this is why you explore. Like, I could do this, and then I can build three houses to get an artifact right here. Alright, we'll take it. Now we need to leave. But what we ended up getting there... what does this do? I do like prolific. Alright, we gotta bail. Do it! Okay, awesome. So, we have moved up to another tier here. And, you know, I can take any of these without danger, get an artifact, and then go to a stage, so that's awesome. And I think we're doing really, really well here. And I just have to say, I enjoy this game a bunch. It's getting harder, but it's just such an interesting, you know, builder, deck building, roguelike. And I'd love to know what your impressions are now seeing three videos. I'm putting links in the description below to the Steam page for Roots of Yggdrasil, so you can check it out, follow along. And I want to say thank you so much, everyone, for watching. Take care.